Hi everyone, today the topic is vapor compression cycle. A liquid evaporating at constant pressure provides the means for heat absorption at constant temperature. Similarly, the condensation of vapor after compression to a higher pressure provides for the rejection of heat at constant temperature. That means the liquid from the condenser is returned to its original state by an expansion process which is carried out in a turbine from which the work is obtained. So when compression and expansion are isentropic, there is a constant entropy, the sequence of processes becomes the vapor compression cycle. Here we represent the vapor compression cycle. So the liquid enters into the evaporator and then it evaporates in the evaporator, and then it moves to the compressor where it is compressed, and then it's condensed in a condenser, and then it is moving into the expander or a turbine where the expansion process takes place, and again it is returned to its original state. That means it is recycled back to the evaporator. So here this is a vapor compression cycle which involves the evaporator, condenser and also the compressor and expander. So for this we can write the equations as the heat absorbed in the evaporator, which we take on the basis of unit mass of fluid, that is QC is equal to delta H, which is equal to H2 minus H1. Similarly, the heat rejected in the condenser is given by QH, which is equal to H3 minus H4. From this, the work done is QH minus QC, which is equal to H3 minus H4 minus H2 minus H1. From this, the coefficient of performance is omega equal to QC by W, that is H2 minus H1 by H3 minus H4 minus H2 minus H1. So these equations and also the vapor compression cycle is used for large installations. Then we go for another topic, that is absorption refrigeration. In vapor compression refrigeration, the work of compression is supplied by an electric motor, but the source of electric energy is heat engine. That means the work for refrigeration comes from heat at high temperature level. That means this suggests the direct use of heat as the energy source for refrigeration. So the absorption refrigeration machine is based on this idea. So the work required by the Carnot refrigerator absorbing heat at temperature TC and rejecting heat at temperature of surrounding spheres, it's given by work done is equal to TS minus TC by TC into QC, where QC is heat absorbed. If source of heat is available at temperature above that of the surroundings, that means at TH, then the work can be obtained from Carnot engine between this temperature and surrounding temperature TS. So then we can write the efficiency as W by QH, which is equal to 1 minus TS by TH. So here you can see, the liquid enters into the evaporator where the heat absorbed for the refrigeration at TC. Similarly, from this evaporator, it enters into the absorber where the heat is discarded to the surroundings at TS. Then it enters into the heat exchanger by means of a pump, and then it enters into the regenerator where the heat is added from the source at TH. From the regenerator, it enters into the condenser where the heat is discarded to the surroundings at TS, and that is temperature of the surroundings. And then it is returned back to its original state into the evaporator. So from this, we can write these equations. So QH is equal to work done into TH by TH minus TS. Then substitution for W gives QH is equal to QC into TH by TH minus TS into TS minus TC by TC. So this value of QH by QC is minimum because Carnot cycles cannot be achieved in practical. So by using these equations, we can evaluate the QH and QC for the absorption refrigeration system. So this is the topics. If you like my description, please subscribe my channel and share my videos. Thank you very much.